I'm Nick Sotera. Today we're going to go over a really basic introduction to guitar and music theory lessons. This is lesson number one, so if this is the first time you're ever holding a guitar, you are in the right place. But if you've had any previous music instruction in the past, feel free to skip ahead. I'm going to touch on the basics first, you know, some vocabulary about the guitar, parts of the guitar, what this thing is that you're holding in your hands. And then we're going to go on to tablature, how to read this, and chords. Ready? So let's get started. Try to mimic me. You want to hold your guitar like this. This is the body of the guitar. Here's the neck, the head, tuning pegs, and these are the strings. You've got six strings on your guitar. And lastly, really important, probably a new word for you, these are called the frets. And this is the first fret, second fret, third fret, four, five, and it keeps going up like that. Anything in between these two metal things. There's dots on the top of your neck that usually goes every odd number until the 12th, and then the 12th has two dots. The 12th fret is special. We'll talk about that one later. So anyways, the different strings have different names known by notes, and then the notes are just a way to describe different pitches in music. So the lowest string would be a low pitch, and then the highest string, high like that. So when you write these strings, a lot of people expect it to be kind of like if I were to just hold up my neck like so, but it's actually flipped. So don't let this confuse you. The lowest one, as if you're on a ladder, is going to be the lowest pitch. So that's this one. See what I mean? How it's kind of flipped like that. But the lowest one, this string right here, is called an E. And play me these ones as I go along, just to kind of get comfortable with it. This is an E string. This is an A string. Next one's a D. You got a G, a B, and then the top one's an E again. So you've got a low E and you've got a high E. Okay, like I said, don't get confused about the bottom and the top. Remember they're switched. So to play a note on a guitar, to get the sound to come out, you're gonna have to, you know, it's a combination of hitting the right string on the right fret. So if you're using a pick, try to hold it like this. I like to hold it with my thumb, so the points kind of come out from that. But a lot of people hold it with their finger, too, if it goes that direction. One thing I do want you to do, and just get used to playing it like this, is scoot up as far as you can see. And then even if it feels uncomfortable right now, you'll thank me later on when you're trying to play faster. When you're holding a guitar, it's very important to make sure that the neck is parallel to the ground. And don't let it go like this. A lot of people do that in the beginning because you're trying to see, you know, make sure you're playing on the right fret. But developing a habit like that, it's going to be better to hold it like this in the long run. So just try to, you know, force yourself to do it like that, and you'll thank me in the future. If you need to lean your head over to make sure you're playing the right note, sure. Okay, so let's get to this. Tablature is really cool. It's a way to read music specifically only for guitar. So when people read notes in band class, you know, universally, staff music has five lines, and notes are really cool. We'll get to that in some other lesson. Anybody can read it for any instrument, but for guitar, tab is just six lines for your six strings, right? So, and then when people write numbers on here, that tells you what fret and what string to play. So it's kind of like longitude and latitude. You know, you gotta find the right one. Let me give you an example. The first song anybody ever learns on guitar, you know, a rock star's first song, Smoke on the Water. So let's start with that. I'm going to write a zero on the bottom string, which remember is low. And zero just means open, or no, zero fret, right? So if this was fret number one, this is fret number two, this is three, this would be zero. Open like that. All right, so play me that. Pick or not pick, doesn't matter at this point. And the second note would be three. So if I write that, then you're going to go, all right, one, two, three. And you're on the bottom string, remember. So take a finger, throw it on right over here. Three. So zero, three would be, yeah. And also keep in mind the different fingers you use when we talk about speed and doing solos and playing quickly like that. We'll talk about that in the future, but just for reference, this is your first finger, your second finger, your third finger, and your fourth finger. For guitar, that's kind of the universal way of doing it. I know piano, the thumb's involved too, so it's different, but don't let that get you confused. If I'm talking about your second finger, I mean it's this one, right? So for my younger students, I like to say, if you're, how old are you? If you're three, you know, that's one, two, three. This is your third finger. If you're four, fourth finger. Four, three, two, one. Okay, so we're gonna play 0, 3, 5. Try to play that. Sound like so. Next part is 0, 3, 6, 5. And then the final part is gonna be 0, 3, 5, 3, 0. Yeah. So okay, put that all together. Let's play it one at a time, okay? So 0, 3, 5, find it all. 0, 3, 5, should sound like that. And then we're gonna go 0, 3, 6, 5. It's gonna sound like so. Use the dots to make sure you're playing in the right place. Sometimes it starts on the 5th fret, sometimes it starts on the 3rd fret, but the dots are on the odd numbers. Remember that. And 0, 3, 5, 3, 0. Okay, so if you put it all together, it sounds like this. When you start to get a little more comfortable when you're playing this, you know, this would be a good time to pause it, write this down, or you know, you don't have to write it down, but pause it and practice this a few times just to kind of get your hand flowing. Your hand's a muscle, right? So the first time you play it, your fingers are going to kind of hurt. You got to build up some calluses. I know everybody talks about that with guitar. That goes away. Don't worry about it. It's not going to be like that forever. It's going to be second nature to put your fingers on frets. But as you're playing this, try to experiment with using different fingers. It's a lot of, you know, you naturally want to start out by going like this and using, you know, your pointer finger for the whole thing, but it's going to be better in the long run to get used to playing different fingers like this. This is a motion that's going to get more natural to you. So try to go 0 and then first finger and third finger. See how I'm doing that? 0, 3, 6, 5. Just something to think about. I'm gonna do one more song for you on tab, but I'm not gonna tell you what it is. I'm gonna see if you can find out for it by yourself. It's one of my favorite songs. Give me a second. And while I'm writing this out, so this one's going to be on multiple different strings. It's a little bit harder. Take your time with it. Don't get frustrated. Nobody picks up a guitar and is Jimi Hendrix. Takes time. Crunched on the end there, sorry about that, but alright, so play me this one at a time, okay? Starting on a 7 on the A string, so let's count it, you know, figure it out, take your time with it. This is E, this is the A string, the second, this is the lowest one, and this is the next string after that, and you're on 7, okay? So all the way up here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or to go faster, you can look at the dots. Sometimes you have 3 dots before that, sometimes the second one, but you know that they're coming on the odd numbers. 7 is an odd number, so put that together. And then take your third finger, bring it on right over here, and play me this note. It's going to take some time to get your pick
or your finger, whichever one you're doing, to get on the correct string. But be patient with yourself. Keep working at it. You just, you know, you gotta put it together. You gotta find the right string and the right fret, and your fingers will get more comfortable as you go on. Anyways, it's gonna be 7, 5. This is not a higher string now, so 7, 5. Got it? And you see, I use my third finger in the beginning, so I don't even have to move my hand. I could just do this all day. If you're using only one finger, that's the problem you're going to have to run into. It's actually more work for you. So I'm going to teach you a lot of things that you can do to chill out more and not have to worry about stuff like that. So, okay. 7, 5, 7, 5, 3, 2. It's going to sound like this if you put it together. You got to move your hand for those last two. Alright, it's the white stripes. So now would be a good time to pause it. You know, save this if you need to and practice this one. Both of the songs I'm not expecting you to get really fast. Work on it. I'm going to give you a bunch to work on. This would be, in my opinion, easily a week's worth of first things to practice. And don't worry about it sounding perfect. It's hard. You're going to have to play around with it on your fingers to make the, you know, make the note sound pure, make it sound strong. Try to play it with the very tips of your fingertips and be in the center as much as you can, and just if you're having trouble producing any sound at all, hold it with your thumb on the back of the guitar, and then, you know, make a fist like that. So put pressure on it. The more pressure you put on it, usually the truer it sounds, especially right in the beginning when your hands are all, you know, weak, not used to doing this kind of stuff. So shake it out, give yourself a break.